We're coming to you live from Tombstone, Arizona. It's sold out Chimera Stadium. This is global warming at its finest, folks. It's a scorching 116 degrees today, but thankfully, it's a dry heat. Both teams hit the field ready to hit each other in this MFL matchup. The Terror Bay Mutineers battle the Cardinal Sins. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If the sound of a torn Achilles followed by laughter and taunting brings a smile to your face, you are tuned to the right place. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow and the MFL crew is coming to you live on game day. Bricks, any thoughts on today's game?
I thought I had one, but I think I might have forgotten it. I remember. I forgot who's playing today.
Careful what you asked for, Grim.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Said the offense was going to be explosive this week. He meant it literally. Second down and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Give him four more downs to punish the defense. Oh, holy smokes! He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. And it's first and 10.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Second down and 10. And he made a mistake there, throwing into tight coverage. The result is he just got crushed. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot. Like he just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Third down, and the punter is warming up. With multiple interceptions, the QB should just throw in the towel. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
That's not fair. Someone should call a penalty on this ref.
The death penalty. Hang him by the nuts.
And that'll bring up third down. Defense had enough with this ref and jumps off sides to kill him. And it's first and 10. And he's off to the races. He's at the 10. Oh, big catch, big run, big touchdown.
Yeah, big deal. Mr. Meat for Brains ran with a ball and didn't fall down.
That should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It's good. Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Second down and 2.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a dark tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
The kind of play you pay the secondary for.
You pay him for the pick six. For this, you just give him a pat on the head and tell him they don't suck.
Second down and 10. First and 10.
Ah, another interception. Easy, give this.
And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed.
The ref that just called that penalty, he was convicted of marrying old ladies and stealing their savings.
That sounds like a good job.
He's right at home here, taking money from coaches, players, and fans.
I even saw him swiping money from the bathroom attendant.
Yeah, who don't do that?
It's first and 10. He refuses to go down. Nicely done for a first down. Oh, no, that was totally unnecessary. I got to see that one again.
It was also freaking awesome. I hope they have raincoats in the front row because that was splattering everywhere.
And it's first and 10.
Sure, my baby sister can throw further than that, but she doesn't have to play against goddamn monsters.
And that'll be second and 8 to go. And I've had it. I'm running out of excuses for this QB. But, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. First and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6.
A boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
He might have managed to dig out a yard on that one.
Not my yard. Got too much buried in, you know, the usual money, bodies, coffee cans filled with, well, you know, mostly coffee. Tastes better, like Eskimos burying salmon heads, kimchi. Fermented anything really tastes good.
Man,
he's leaving a wake of destruction in his path. down and eight. Caught for the first down. First down and seven. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll bring up second and one.
Hot one, hot two.
Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
And the offense has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to eat those last two runners for dessert, Quinn.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
I thought the only tie we'd see would be a noose. Instead, they're in a dead heat. Tie game at the end of one. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
First and ten. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him.
Going in circles.
And it's first and ten. More to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Second down and nine. Nice run there for 8 yards. And that'll bring up third and one. He's leaving a wake of destruction in his path, and the body toll continues to climb. The offense lost another running back and only two remain on the roster. When a team loses all their running backs, they lose their ability to run the ball.
Yeah, like if I rip out your tongue, you won't be able to speak. Tell us something we don't know, genius.
And he lines up for the field goal attempt, trying to ignore the defense's threats of murder. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
It's first and ten. He just put that guy out of his misery and says, who's next? Oh, you knew you were going to see a lot of carnage today, folks. These teams have bad blood between them. Apparently, they got it from the same bloodmobile that usually parks outside next to the taco truck. Raccoon rabies blood is my thought. Always a player's favorite.
Keep a good mutant.
He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. And it's first and ten. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Come on! And he finds open space, is running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch!
And it's first and ten. Good thing they don't have drug testing in the end. And another interception. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. The 10. Man, this guy's a game breaker. He picks off the QB and returns the ball for a touchdown. That's how you do it at home, kids. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and ten. And picks up maybe a deuce at most.
Speaking of deuces, I got a, hey, you got a dollar for the bathroom attendant? He threatened me if I didn't tip him next time.
And he held on to that one for a first down. And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
And the quarterback throws another pick. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor. Finish him.
And it's first and ten. And we're at the 2-minute warning.
I gotta pee.
Second down and a lot. Oh, man, I love this dirty. Oh, nice hit. You can put a pitchfork in this guy because he's done.
And now the ground screw is going to use a pitchfork to toss him onto the mutant meat wagon. Hey, Grim, wouldn't it make more sense to use a spatula?
Yeah, good point.
Third down and a pussy hair.
Love the sound of bones snapping and cracking. I mean, when they're not yawn.
Timeouts aren't just for offense, Grim?
Well, they usually are, but sometimes the defense thinks they're helping out in their own special way. And out comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. him back nicely. And he, oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big peregrin. You're right.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. And he's running like a moose right now. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. Oh, what a run there. Touchdown. No one was going to stop him. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
He could go all the way.
First down. He hit that line.
Oh, and you can bury that guy because he is dead.
Oh, did you see what number he was? I gotta check it off my dead mutant bingo card. I only need one more.
The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock-blocked the clock.
The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused.
Oh, and he might have just saved a touchdown on that deflection. And the quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. Does the QB know which team he's on?
I don't even know where I'm at.
Man, what a hit. That guy is not getting up. And it's first and ten. Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And that's the end of the second quarter. Someone will need to pull together some bribe money as they head to their lockers. Stay with us for the Halftime Show, brought to you by our friends at Monsatan Industries. We make genetically altered frankenfood you'll have fun trying to identify. Well, the third quarter coming up. Bricks, this game has been a hot mess so far.
Yeah, kind of like the morning after eating hot chicken wings. It's a hot mess on the exit ramp, if you know what I mean.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And the quarter throws a supersonic missile to his receiver. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
And it's first and 10. Rumbles for 9 on that play. Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. First and 4. Was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10.
Another interception. Geez, you give this guy a bigger paycheck than everybody else combined.
Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's fantastic.
And it's first and 10. Come on, man. You gotta catch that.
I don't catch anything, Grim. I'm retired.
Second down and 10. And the defense calls the thunderclap dirty trick. Man, that's gotta hurt.
That'll make the hair on your corpse stand straight up.
Oh, nice hit.
Yo, man, nobody can touch you an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot
three. Oh, and they just deflated the quarterback's balls right there. Second down and long. Oh, and the ball falls to the ground. That's incomplete.
He needs to throw it when the receiver can catch it. What's he doing?
And groundbreaking analysis has all of their bricks.
Oh, thank you. I do my part.
Third down and, well, good luck.
Hot one.
I hope you covered your ears. He's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, Grim.
Hey, man, he's on schedule now. Oh, yeah.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10. Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Briggs? Wonder what made him so mad.
It was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it specifically for the owners of the inclusives, but not the guests.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Right now, what day is it?
And it's first and 10. Oh man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on.
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
The greatest, I tell you.
The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Ben?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
Second down and 6. And there's another pick. Man, this quarterback must have learned a lot about shit. Boom, and he's dead.
Oh, bingo, bingo, bingo. I got bingo, Grim.
He's at the 10. Touchdown. And he rumbles that one into the end zone. Nicely done.
I can't run like that unless it's coupon night at Taco Hell. He has better footwork, though, than me. On account of not clenching his cheeks, though.
Well, a little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, with a punishing hit. Second down and 7.
Hot one, hot two.
I'm running out of excuses for this QB. He broke free and has open field in front of him. The 10, close but no cigar. First down and 9. Great throw, great catch, and that puts 6 points on the board.
The defense couldn't do anything to stop a throw that good, Ben.
You mean aside from bribing the ref, killing the quarterback, or actually playing some D?
And here comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Briggs. It certainly does. High five! And It's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
He had nowhere to go and got nothing out of it. Second down and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
You can't keep a good
man. And he finds open space, is running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
He's at the 30.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful. Oh my God, a man from prison just came onto the field.
That's the ref, you idiot. Let's see what the penalty is. It's first and ten.
Hot one.
That's a 6 yard gain on that catch. And that'll be second down and four.
Hot one. Hot two.
And the quarterback throws another pick. He should have eaten his Sleeties this morning. Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Oh, the defender almost picked off the ball on that one. Two quarterbacks remaining on the roster. They better be careful because when those guys die, it's forfeit city. Second down and 10. And that's another turnover. Now the offense is getting kills. This is really a violent game, guys. The offense has only two linemen left on the offense and will need to play shorthanded the rest of the game.
Say mean things about short people, Grim. At least they don't look down on people.
And it's first and ten. Boom! Dead and down.
He delivered the freaky fast ham sandwich with extra mustard for the death blow. Speaking of ham sandwiches, I'm gonna go grab one. You want anything?
No, still working on my salami here, Bricks. Thanks.
That's what she said. Didn't work that time. It was close, though.
Yep.
And it's first and ten. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown! Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
Any proud of that?
Yeah.
Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. And it's first and ten. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down.
Come on, that was a cheap shot. That's why I love this guy. And so do the fans. The third quarter mercifully ends. If this game is as painful to watch as we are to listen to, then please accept our apologies. This one is just about over.
I got the thing stuck in my ear again.
And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and forever. I don't know whose eyes the QB is using, but can we get him some new ones? He is fighting for every yard. Oh, what a punching hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. The offense is losing quarterbacks faster than teams lose their minds at spring break. They're down to their last QB before they have to forfeit. And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense... And that's another pick. Oh, that's a big-time hit. You ever been hit like that before, Bricks?
Have you seen my...
The offense lost their final quarterback. Lucky for them, they're on defense now or the game would be over.
So all the other team has to do is punt to force a forfeit?
That would be correct, Bricks. It's first and 10. Boom! And like the Titanic, his ship just went down.
Hey, I almost got that mutant bingo. All I need is 77 to bite it.
The Cardinal fans ruthlessly destroy the opposition and win by forfeit. There's not much left of the opposition, and the fans are loving it. There was only one way this game was going to end, and that was in a forfeit.
That's not quite true, Grim. The alien spacecraft could have crashed into the stadium and ended the game. How about it?
How about if you shut the hell up right now? We go down to the field and listen to what the NBA...